Guys, we're going to play some Greek music. Let's play some Greek music. What do you guys think? Let's play some Greek music, guys. Let's play some Greek music, everybody. I have heard some amazing Greek music. Let me see. Here we go, everybody. Guys, I can't beat this song. This song is so wonderful. This must have been the music that was listened to when the Athenians and the Spartans were killing each other. This must have been the music of the Greek auxiliaries of Rome when they assailed the walls of Jerusalem. Let's listen to this beautiful music from Greece, everybody. Opa. I mean, we can't beat this. Have a good night, sweet body fit. Big hugs, everybody. Break out the ouzo, absolutely. Or the rakia. Or the arak, if you're from Lebanon. Russians have got great tradition in literature, absolutely. Ed Sheeran parody. Play it. Golden feta. I'm in love with the gyro. Me too. Not celebrating tomorrow? Absolutely, I'll be celebrating tomorrow, but I won't be with you guys, sadly. Here we go. This guitar. He starts out with this Greek kithara. He's playing the kithara. He's not playing the guitar. He's playing the kithara. Okay? Like the Spanish guitarra. Then he starts playing the violin. Listen to this. The violin kicks in. Now the kithara, or as somebody said, the bouzouki is now coming in. Orthochristos, the name of the singer is Konstantis Pistiolis. So he's played the guitar, the violin, he's returned to the guitar. Now he's going to start playing the reed instrument, specifically the clarinet. So let's listen to this part right here. Now guys, the style of this music comes from a specific region of Greece up north. We're talking about the Pontic region of Greece, or the music of Epirus, which is closer to Albania. When you listen to Albanian music, it sounds similar to this style of music. Let's listen to this. (Laughs) he does this scale that I really, really appreciate. You know what? What am I doing? Let's just watch the dude play. What am I doing trying to steal the show here, guys? Come on. So I love the scale that he does. He's literally playing in his bedroom, by the way. It's really cool. Okay? He does the scale that I really love. He does the scale. Well, listen to this. Listen closely. Listen closely. It's this bum 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 da 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 da. It's really, really nice. This music, when you listen to it, my friend, the spirit of Thucydides is running through you, okay? The spirit of Herodotus is here. The spirit of Homer is still lives, everybody. The spirit of the Greek auxiliaries of Rome who assailed the walls of Jerusalem during the Roman-Jewish war is still alive in our hearts when this music is playing. Listen to some more of this masterpiece, everybody. Now he starts singing, right? Now, so we heard the guitar, we heard the violin, we heard, as someone said, the oboe. Now we're going to hear the instrument of the human voice. And what he is saying in this song, it's very interesting. It's very spiritual, this song. This is not romantic music. He's not singing about a woman. He's not singing about some woman that screwed him over, any bullshit like that. He's singing about the human soul. That's what this man is singing. It's like the spirit of Socrates is still alive. He's singing about the human condition. He's saying, oh, you man who is in hell. This is what he's saying in the song. He's saying, you who is in hell, you who are in hell. Are there beautiful women to play with? Are there beautiful women to have fun with? Are you enjoying parades? Are your devotees praising you? You who are in hell, are you having fun? The song is about the finite nature of human life. The finite, the limited nature of human life. How, yes, on Earth we can have fun and all these people are getting laid, they're having fun. But what about the human soul? What about the eternal state of man? And that's what this song is talking about. It's very spiritual. This is very, very spiritual music. Let's listen to some more of this. Χάρης εσύ που είσαι στον Άρη, μερακλείδες πως παίρνουν στον άνθρο σου σοτάρι. Και πουν κράσι να πίνουν εγκλαρί να μαβαράν. The way he does that oboe, man, it slaps. In America, the oboe is considered a jazz instrument. That's considered, that's music for jazz music, right? It's just some jazz shit you hear in some stupid club. Dude, this guy hits the oboe so differently, man. This music hits your soul. And that scale that he has, that run tan run tan run tan na ra 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 na ra 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 na ra ra. It's a Greek song, Yamas Maria Sagapo. Imagine listening to something like this during the rat. Yeah. Are you single? Yes, absolutely, I'm single. Do I look like a man who's got a life? Let's be real here. Here I am listening to Greek music on a Friday night with a bunch of strangers drinking vodka. Do I look like a guy who's got married, who's got a wife and kids? Let's be real here. Come on now. It's extremely precise. Yeah, you can hear the passion. Absolutely. Absolutely, you guys. A Balkan person can feel this a little deeper. Yeah, yes, this music is closer to the Balkan ways of singing, specifically Albanian music. Yep. Για πες μας για τους πλούσιους με τους πόλους παράτες, τη μαύρη τη φτωχολόγια που ζουν οι φουκαράτες. have to keep this music secret. We can't let the world know about this music. This music is too special to be famous. This music is too special to be famous. Imagine if this music became super world famous. You know what's going to happen. Some rapper is going to take this. He's going to take this song, right? And he's going to be like, it's going to be like, and then he's going to be like, oh, yeah. He's like, man, I had like 20 Greek bitches up in the club in the island of Patmos because they know that I'm from the street, from the utmost, because they be coming up knowing that I'll be created, knowing that I'll be facing these fools up in the berated towers of Babel. Like, and then they'll use this dude's voice as the chorus and they'll totally rape the song. I mean, you know that will happen, right? If this music ever became mainstream. We can never let this music become famous. This video, my friends, only has 725,000 views. Now, 725,000 views is a lot of views, don't get me wrong. It's a lot of views, everybody. But it's not 6 billion people. It's not a billion views. It's not a billion. We can't let this become super famous. We can't. We have to keep this. We need to protect this music at all costs. This is something very special, guys.
Διαβάτε εσείς τέλεια ανθρώπι αυτό που περπατάτε. Βόξες και λεφτά εδώ παιδιά μου δεν περνάνε. Όσοι έχουν καλή καρδιά αυτοί καλό περνάνε. Τα λεφτά τα χρήματα στον άδει δεν περνάνε. Σαν τους θα τα αφήσετε και θα σας πλάστε.
He starts doing a little bit of dissonance to make you appreciate the sound of the song. Something else I want to add here, guys. Greek literature, Greco-Roman literature. Very, very special. Thucydides, Herodotus, Diodotus Siculus, Josephus. Greco-Roman literature. Greco-Roman literature is written in a very beautiful way. Powerful. It's very impactful. Strabo, Tacitus. There's something very sublime about the style of literature that springs forth from Greco-Roman literature. The Greco-Roman world, the Greco-Roman soul. When you read modern-day books, they are full of masturbation. They are full of writing styles that are paralleled to the style of Slavoj Žižek, which is just verbal masturbation. When you read Marx and when you read the Hegelian dialectic of Marx, what you will find is that in the phenomenology of the spirit of the great zeitgeist, that this Marx had his totality in the manifestation of today in the current era that we are currently viewing because we read Marx. We read Marx, everybody, Marx. And that's why Jordan Peterson is so popular, because in the Marxian view, certain people will manifest as capitalist agents of fame, and that's what happens, everybody. That's what happens. That's reading modern books, full of masturbation, full of words like mitigation, amelioration. It's all masturbation at the end of the day. But when you read Thucydides, and how he talks about how the Athenians and the Spartans went to war with each other, how there was a civil war amongst the Athenians, how the Athenians killed each other, how there was a war between the poor and the rich. When you read Josephus and how he talks about how the Hebrews went to war with the Romans, how the Hebrews said that no foreigner can sacrifice in the temple, not even Caesar, and Caesar saw this as a declaration of war. And how straightforward the literature is, how honest the literature is. There's something beautiful about it. When you read Herodotus and how he talks about this huge tower in Babylon, and you were just brought to the book of Genesis when it talks about the Tower of Babel. or when you read Josephus and you are just brought to the gospel when Jesus is criticizing the Jewish elites and how they mistreated the foreigners. And how you read Josephus, how he describes how the Jews were attacking the Goyim and how they were killing Greeks. And you read of how the Romans were too afraid to assail the walls of Jerusalem because the Jews were pouring hot boiling oil on the down on the soldiers who were trying to climb the walls. And how there was one Syrian man, he was a Syrian man who was a soldier of Rome. Josephus describes him as a dark skin, a Syrian man of dark complexion who was of a wiry composition. And how he said, "I will assail the walls." And he assailed the walls with such ferocity that the Jews feared him. The Hebrews feared him. And he pulled his sword out. And any Hebrew fighter who approached him, he slew them. And he gave such a morale boost to the other soldiers that they assailed the walls of Jerusalem and took the victory over Israel. Reminding us of that verse in the Old Testament when it speaks of Absalom and how he fought against his father David. And it says, and David, with his alliance with the Philistines who were truly ethnically Greek, David, in his alliance with the Philistines, fought against Israel. And with this historical reality in our minds and in our hearts, I play the muse of the Greco-Roman world. Play the song. Could make better music than anything I hear on the radio today. Isn't that amazing? You hear songs on the radio today. Songs on the radio today that literally have billions invested in them, millions of dollars invested in them. And this dude is singing in his fucking bedroom, making better music than anything you hear today. Dude, that is insane. The system is so broken, guys. It is so broken. Let's listen to more. How his voice assails the mountain. Watch how it assails Mount Olympus. Listen to this. It assails Mount Olympus right here. Listen to how his voice just assails the mountaintops. Listen to this, guys. Listen to this. Singing about the realities of life in his bedroom. He's a one-man show. He's playing the guitar, the violin, the oboe. He's singing. He's mixing all the sound together. Dude, the guy is a musical freaking genius. What is the name of this song? I gotta read to you guys the lyrics. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can find the lyrics here. Let's find the lyrics here. Hold on. Okay, hold on a second, guys. Dude, the song is 10 minutes of pure sublime experience. Let's get the lyrics out here, everybody. The lyrics are, so tell us, O hare, hare meaning rabbit, rejoice, you who are in Hades, you who are in hell. Now again, this is Greek music. Let's compare it to our American friends. Iris by the Goo Goo Dolls. And I'd give up forever to touch you, 'cause I know that you feel me somehow. You're the closest to heaven that I'll ever be, and I don't want to go home right now. This is the music from our American friends. Now, this music isn't bad. Don't get me wrong. It's not bad. It is the music of a torn soul, of a wounded animal. Let's go to our Greek friends here. So tell us, O rabbit, rejoice, you who are in hell. How do the now the translation doesn't do a good job here because it says, how do the maraklis pass in your dark, in your black dark? Now the word maraklis, I'm trying to remember what maraklis means. Let me look this up real quick. Hold on. Maybe orthos can help me out here. Let's see here. Greek, maraklis. Let me see something here. I think maraklis is like the poor, I think, or I no, actually no, sorry. Maraklis is like your devotees, right? Your followers, the people who revere you. So he's saying you who had all this fun on earth, right? How do your devotees pass in your black darkness? Do you have wine to drink, clarinet to get bored, and beautiful girls to party with? These are the lyrics of this song. Tell us about the rich with the many parades, the black or the poor. How do the, now the translation doesn't do a good job here. How do the Foukaredes live? Now, Foukaredes, I looked into this. Foukaredes is a Greek word that, believe it or not, comes from an Arabic word, fakir. I know that sounds bad, right, in English. Fakir. Fakir means something like poor people. So, how do the poor live under your reign? Do they have wine to drink, clarinet to get bored, and beautiful girls to party with? It's basically saying that this life is limited, it is finite, and you better focus on your own soul before anything else. That's basically the morale of this song. Hare is hados death. Ah, reaper, not hare. Okay, so the translation is wrong on that one. So it means death. Okay. American simp music, yeah. Meraklis means the cool guys. Ah, okay. Meraklis. Okay. The name of the song is, I can't read it. Foukaredes means despondent and poor. Right, it's the same thing. It comes from Arabic, my friend. I am amazed how many Greek words come from Arabic. Fakir, which means poor. Foukaredes. Yep, absolutely. Absolutely. I try to search this up, but it's not popping up. Let me give you guys the link. Let me give you guys the link. Y'all, this is the link. I'm gonna speak Texan right now. Y'all, here's the link. Y'all, here's the link, guys. Slavoj Zizek. Yeah, I know. When you read Marx, when you smoke cocaine as much as I do and read Marx, you become a genius like me. yeah. Theodore Shuba, you either, okay, yeah, you know what? Alcohol helps me express myself better. It makes my brain feel very fluid. I have a very good time talking to you guys. It's a lot of fun. The spirit of Russia is alive. True, this is more like a journey, an experience. Thanks for introducing me. Absolutely. This is an amazing piece of music. What is the name of the song? I put the link in the chat, my friend. You can see it. The name of the song is, I can't read Greek. Let's see here. Fokar, me poor people who have called me a cheap fokar. Yeah, absolutely, guys. Let's listen to some more of this music. he assails the mountain with the oboe, and then he assails the mountain again with his voice. He goes, ba-da-da, na-da-da, right? Well, listen to this. Almost a playfulness with the oboe when he there's a playfulness, almost a Baroque style in the song. And according to Ortho Christo, it says here the rendition of the title is "Tell us death, I implore you." It's like that Christian verse, "O death, where is thy sting?" I mean, it's right there. Piece of music that he got here that I found today that I want to play for you guys. This song is pretty much over, so there's not much to listen to. Let's listen to some more of this music from the land of Hereditas. Internet is acting a little bit retarded right now. Where is it? Let's listen to some more of this music. Okay, so there's another piece of music that this guy made. This isn't some more. Where is it here? I think this is it. Yeah, the ornamentation in his voice is insane. I completely agree. It's amazing. And this guy's a one-man show. It truly is amazing how truly talented people are not recognized in this world. They're not recognized. What the hell is this bullshit? Okay, guys, this is more... Let's listen to some more Greek music. This is the music of Epirus. True Balkan music. Let's listen to some more of this. Let's play! Guys, I'm going to have to play my own music because, you know, so many times I've asked you guys to make music recommendations to me. And some of you guys send me great music, but most of you, I'm telling you, most of you guys come on here and you're like, oh, yeah, play this song by Sabaton. And it's like, I can't tolerate this. This is so exhausting. I can't do it. I mean, we start with the drums. Now we're going to go to the oboe. There's some more. This is not an oboe. This is more like a reed instrument. Almost like a medieval reed instrument, like a mizmar. But let's hear some more. We got that snake chanter music playing. Let's hear this. And when you listen to medieval music from France or from England, you hear this type of music. That nah, 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 nah. Guys, this comes from the ancient. This is the inheritance of the ancient Indo-European peoples. People don't realize that that reed music you hear from the medieval period, that's ancient. That's very ancient music. Techno is the best. Yeah. There's a whole world out there. It's not just Goo Goo Dolls. It's not just Sabaton. It's not just some whatever bullshit you heard. Dude, there's so much better music out there you guys have never even heard of. We're going beyond the veil. We are transcending the veil here. 100% look up Faria Faraji on YouTube. He is Canadian-Iranian musicologist who goes deep into musical history. I gotta look that up. Is there a particular video that you would recommend? Because when you listen to renditions of medieval music from England or from France, you hear this type of instrument. This na 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 na. The Greeks are doing it. The Macedonians are doing it. The Iranians are doing it. Guys, this is ancient Indo-European stuff. And it's so funny. You have these racists who come out and they're like, oh yeah, the music of the ancient, the artwork of the, or the civilization of the Indo-European world. They're listening to freaking black metal bullshit. This is the real music, guys. And this guy's not even a right winger. He's some Greek Antifa guy. It's a wonder hasn't been any snakes coming out of the, yeah. Literally saying the apple of Aman. Now he keeps saying Aman, Aman. Where does Aman come from? This word Aman. We don't even know what this word means. Aman is a Middle Eastern term. It comes from the, most likely this was given to the Greeks by the Ottomans when they controlled the Greeks. Aman is an expression of woe. It's like the Jewish phrase oy vey. You know, oy vey, oy gevalt, oy vey, oy gevalt, right? Or, oh my God, or oh no, right? It's an expression of woe. Aman, 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 right? It's an expression of woe. You see this in the Palestinian world. You see this in all Middle Eastern music. Aman, aman, aman. The Greeks do the same exact thing. So he's saying, apple of Aman. That's what he's saying in this song. Apple of woe, apple of woe, apple of woe, apple of woe. The fruit of woe. He's repeating himself over and over again in the song. He's saying, fruit of woe, apple of woe. Oh, Aman, vravya se ke puta.
Και λέγει μα το νου. just not what you would have to listen to for all eternity if you had to listen to something. If I had to listen to a style of music for all my life, I would listen to Greek music. That's what I would listen to. Magical, guys. That is some magical music. That's some magical stuff. Oh, Lord. Hold on. How do I get this thing? Yeah. There's another piece of music. Dude, this guy... There's a guy dancing in this song. It's... This guy is so drunk off his ass. Hold on. Let me try to find it real quick. Na ra ra man, ya ra ra man, man, ya ra da ra na ra ra da ra, da na ra da ra ra ra. It's great music. This is amazing music, guys. Wait, this guy is so drunk off his ass. Hold on. Wait. Inputs. Input. Okay, we're good. Audio is working. I think this is the song. Hold on. No, that's not the song. Is this the song? Dang it. Dude, there's one piece of music where he's playing guitar. It sounds so good. Let's hear some more of this. Let's hear some more of this music. This is a guitar piece. Why isn't this playing? What's going on? Hello, hello? This is not playing for some reason. Song where he plays from the oud, which is a Middle Eastern instrument. Listen to this music. Isn't that a cute pussy? Isn't that an adorable pussy? That's a beautiful Greek pussy right there. That is a beautiful, gorgeous, clean Greek pussy right there. I'm back. The missus went to bed. Again, another example of the travails of marriage, everybody. The lyrics are okay. I'm just joking. The music melody is great. I'm just not sure the staccato rhythm is exactly to my taste, but others definitely enjoy. Okay, fair enough. The break between the lyrics and the melody of the wood instrument is a little more jarring than I would like. I can play banjo. That's cool. Listen to this from Fadia Faraji on YouTube. Hikanatoi, epic Byzantine music, is his own composition with Greek instruments. Okay, I'll play that. Let me just hear this. I like how there's a mix of emotions in this expression and within this particular piece of music. I really like that. Let's hear some more. Ρίξτα τα μάλια σου, ρίξτα απ' τα παραθύρια.
я нашу. Рік стата маляшу, рік стата пара твір яшу. Скало патината кану.
So it's amazing how he transitions from being sad. He's like, nah, 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 nah. He's very sad. Now there's like this ascendancy in his voice, and now all of a sudden there's this expression of happiness. It's amazing.
Μ' ανέβω στα φρύδια σου.
It's almost like Indian music, like Sanskrit sitar music almost. It reminds me. I'm going to take a nap to recharge batteries, be back in 20. All right, cool, man. Enjoy the rest. Hope you have good dreams. And what's funny is that, guys, this is real music. Like, this is real Greek music. This is not some BBC bullshit where they're like, the music of the ancient Greeks. Watch some white Anglo-Saxon man play the harp. It's the music of the ancient Greeks. It's the music dedicated to Athena and Aphrodite. Like, this is real Greek music.
Κάντα τα μάλια σου κατά κατά σκαλές να ανέβω. Κάντα τα μάλια σου κατά κατά σκαλές να ανέβω. Να φιλήσω.
Now the lyrics are a little interesting here. According to Ortho Christos, throw your hair from the window so I can use it as steps to climb to your eyelashes. I mean, it's a little bit like Iris, right? It's a little bit like Iris. It's not too far apart. It's not too far apart from Iris, right? And I'd give up. Wait, hold on. And I'd give up forever to touch you, cause I know that you feel me somehow. This song was playing in every Applebee's in America. Don't, come on. Wait, not this one. Where's the other one? Here it is. Now there's another piece of music that he does. Man, it's like you see this drunk Greek guy dancing in the video, because he's doing like a live performance at a bar, or it's like a restaurant somewhere. Let me try to find it. Dang it, it's so annoying. It's amazing how you'll find every video that you've watched except the one that you're looking for. I always find that amazing. What's up with this? Do you guys know this woman that's just taking over Instagram now, Pearl, where she's like, men want a good woman. Men want a good woman. Women don't want good men. Have you ever seen this? She's like a redheaded Catholic girl. She's like a redheaded Catholic girl. She's like, men want good women. Women don't want good men. They want bad men. They go for bad men. They love bad men. Have you heard this woman? She has taken over YouTube, Pearl. I swear it's a psyop, guys. It's further proof. Listen, you could put Andrew Tate in prison for the rest of his life. Pearl's gonna pop up. Are you gonna arrest Pearl? The song. This is not the music that I'm looking for. Is this the song? I think this is the one. this is not the song. This is the song. You used to play the trumpet. That's cool. I used to play the Irish whistle. Pearl. It's Pearl, guys. Pearl. She's a white trad girl. She's like, women want bad men. Men want good women. Yeah. I play the vodka. That's awesome. So you know things are about to get serious. Dancing. Right here. This is so funny. Y'all thought the bagpipes came from Scotland. You guys thought the bagpipes came from Scotland. No, it didn't. It's ancient. This guy looks like he just came back, like he just came from work and he's entered the bar and he's listening to this music. That's what it looks like to me. Because he's got some kind of a uniform on. Looks like he's a government employee or something. Guys, so hello dude, nice sound, a little bit similar to Corvus Corax's music. Okay guys, so let's do some musical recommendations. I played you guys my music. Let's hear your guys's music. Let's hear your musical recommendations. Let's go. All right, hit me up with the recommendations. I'll play them right now and I'll criticize them. What do you guys think? That sound fair enough or what? Hit me up with your musical recommendations. Somebody recommended Motown. Who recommended Motown? Hit me up with some Motown. Motown. Let's play some of this garbage. Oh, this is some old disco shit. All right, guys. We just heard the music of the ancient Greco-Roman civilization. So let's hear some Motown now. complete garbage. All right, Over by Evans Blue. Let's hear this.